This video is dedicated for, well, I don't know how to pronounce it, but I'm going to kind of say it Spanish-wise. Salumable one, uno. Salumable one. Thank you for requesting this video, and I hope it answered your questions. Let me know if you had any more questions or any ideas for videos, and I could answer the questions in the comments or make a quick video. Okay, so I just got a request for another video to talk more about my C-sections, so I'm excited to do that. And if you have any questions or comments, please leave them below. Try to make this quick because my baby just woke up. He's happy right now, but you never know how long it's going to be. So I've had 4 C-sections in 5 years. Okay, so the first question that was asked was about the risk from going from 3 C-sections, then another one. So from the 3rd to the 4th. So for me, thankfully, each time I healed well and I had no scar tissue. So you can ask your doctor if you had a lot of scar tissue develop after the last C-section. But for me, the risks were all the same. And my doctor had a woman who just had her 7th C-section, and she healed quickly fine too. So for me, there were no different risks from going from 3 to 4 C-sections, thankfully. And then how did I feel after? I felt the same. After each C-section, I felt the same. And how long does it take to recover? I think, for me, if you follow the tips in that other video, it's about a week. So you have the surgery, and then a week, it's like a week of not fun, of pain and just not being a great time. So I would say look for a week. Obviously, so in the hospital I tried to walk. It honestly wasn't that much. It was a small area, and you have to go really slow, but I still tried to walk a few minutes before I had to go and sit down again. So I hope in the last video, I hope it doesn't sound like I was doing like marathon walking, because I wasn't. And then once I got home, you know, for 2 C-sections, we were in a tiny one-room basement apartment, so there wasn't a lot of place to walk around. But I still got up, I would go get the diapers, I would make the bottle, I would take care of the children as much as I could. So you'll notice that each day there'll be less and less pain. Okay, so let's talk about the times between. So let me show you, I wrote it down. So my first C-section was in March of 2014. And that just ended up being basically an emergency C-section. I was induced and in labor for a day and a half, and then every time a contraction came, his heartbeat would drop, the baby's. So we just decided to have a C-section. And then after that, it was all planned and scheduled, which makes it really nice and easy. So this is the question, how much time between each C-section? So there was 2 years and 3 months from the 1st to the 2nd, and it felt just the same. Well, it was even easier because I wasn't induced and didn't go through all the pain. and so it's even easier once they're scheduled. And then I had 1 year and 4 months. So I got pregnant when he was 7 months old. I was pregnant with the next one. and everything went fine. There wasn't any problems with the C-section scar. I didn't have any extra pain. Each pregnancy was pretty much the same. And then the 3rd one was in 2019, just last year. And that was 1 year and 8 months apart between those ones. So I hope this answers your question. And then in this one, I decided to tie my tubes. We were done having children. And when I decided to tie my tubes and to be done, they recommend like 3 C-sections. But then my doctor was like, oh, I just had a woman who had her 7th one. So, you know, like you can't use that as an excuse. But I felt like I was finished. I felt good. Okay, so the risk, they were just the same for me. Thankfully I healed really well after each C-section. I'm right here. Here is number 3. Can I see you? Hi, Christopher. Oh, Peter's talking to the baby. Okay, so I hope that answers your question. I felt the same after all the C-sections. You feel pretty horrible the first week, but even toward the end of that week, like day 5, 6, 7, you notice that you feel better each day. Healing time, it was the same. Yeah, there was no difference between C-section 3 and C-section 4 for me. The pregnancies got harder toward the end, and my doctor said that pregnancy 4, 5, 6, you're going to feel more pain toward the end of the pregnancies. Each pregnancy, you'll hurt more. Your body just hurts more, I guess, the bones and your joints and ligaments, and there's more back pain. But you also have more children to look after, so... So I hopefully this answered your question. I'll edit this real quick and post it. Thank you so much for requesting this. I'm going to go and look up your name again so I can say it correctly. And I really appreciate that. Yeah. Have a great day. Let me know if you have any more questions. Each pregnancy had its own adventure. Thank you for hanging out. I hope you have a really great day. Bye. Jeez. This is number 2, Jonathan. And this is number 4. Whoop, Peter. Hi. He just turned 6 months. And the oldest is in kindergarten, so he don't have him. Hi. Hi. So my husband, their father, is from Mexico, so we have a fun... This is a fun mixture of the genes, huh? But they all seem to get really dark in the sun, so that's good. Nobody burns like I do. Is he having a snack?
Uh-huh. It's this.
Whoa.